In most African countries, pretty much everyone employs a domestic worker, is related to a domestic worker, or is a domestic worker. 3 years ago, I reported on the plight of these workers and followed the lives of housegirls Scovia, Mercy, and Esther. Now I'm back and eager to meet up with the girls again.
Oh my goodness.
I want to find out how things have changed for them since we last met, where they are now, and most importantly, what the future holds for them.
Nafurahi. I see a nice idea.
Najua ndoto yangu itakuwa itakuja ikue ya ukweli.
My first stop is Kampala, capital of Uganda. And my first task, to reacquaint myself with the original Housegirls film, which resonated with millions of viewers across Africa. The film shone a light on Kenya's domestic workers, 83% of who are paid below minimum wage, work long hours, and are often mistreated by their employers. The three girls I followed each had their own issues. Mercy was involved in a court case after accusing her employer of cruelty. Scovia was trying to make money to support her grandmother back in Uganda. And Esther was struggling with how she was being treated.
Looking back at this, it all feels like a long time ago, but also very immediate. The stories of Scovia, Esther, and Mercy never really left me, and I'm keen to find out how they are now.
Three women, all connected by one thing, the experience they had while working as housegirls. I'm heading to Busia, in the far east of Uganda, close to the Kenyan border. And I'm going back to school.
I've not seen Scovia in school since we dropped her here a few years ago, so I'm really excited to see how she's doing.
Hi, Scovia.
Nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, my goodness. It's been a long time.
Scovia managed to escape domestic work and with the help of a charity and Bettina Natumanya, the school's deputy, was able to resume her studying.
So this is your bed, Scovia.
Yes.
This is where you have to get up at 3 in the morning because you're preparing for exams.
Yes.
Is it very different from home?
Yes. Because here at school, most of my friends are here. Mm. But for there at the home, I don't have friends. I like studies.
But it hasn't been all plain sailing. There was the little matter of the COVID-19 lockdown to deal with.
How did it affect you?
I got pregnant. By the grandmom advised me that when I gave birth, then I get back to school.
And why was that so important for you to come back to school?
I just want to give a responsible mother so that I can take care of her.
Having a baby hasn't stalled Scovia's progress.
She got the challenge of being pregnant. She didn't abort. She said, no, I'm going to produce this child and I'm going back to school. She has a dream. Remember, you found her doing domestic work. She did not like it, but she went to look for money to support her. She wants to pursue the law.
Why do you want to be a lawyer?
You know, in our community, men, they mistreat their wives. So when I become a lawyer, maybe I can protect them and that.
From where she began from, now where she is, there is hope that she's going to make it.
I'm so proud of how well Scovia's doing, in spite of the difficulties she's endured. But now, I want to get back on the road to catch up with another former house girl.
It's been about 3 years now since the last time I saw Esther. We've stayed in touch, but that doesn't come close to seeing the person. And I am a bit worried because of just how badly the odds were stacked up against her. So I just don't know what we'll find.
Esther lives in Namunyu, a small village around 2 hours' drive from Scovia.
That's your most welcome.
Oh, thank you. Is it you? Oh, my goodness.
You're most welcome.
Thank you.
Hey.
Hi.
The family have a small plot of land that's keeping them fed and allowing them to make some money.
Sasa hapa ni mahindi na maragwe tu ndio tunalima.
Kwa hiyo inasaidia na chakula.
Eh.
I can see how close Esther is to her family and why she was so desperate to leave Nairobi and come home.
Are you glad you came home?
Nasikia raha nikikaa home. Sasa at least nikikuwa home sometimes inafurahi than nikikuwa huko Nairobi kama sina kazi.
Esther's dream when she was doing domestic work was to open a shop.
Huko Nairobi nilikuja huko nikaanza biashara ya kuuza nguo. Business na ilikuwa inaendelea vizuri. Sasa unaona nasi hiyo business na ilikuwa inanisaidia sana na niko na dream.
But a combination of factors shattered her dream.
Kwanza babangu ndiye alikuwa mgonjwa. Sasa pesa nilikuwa anga naye nikamsaidia nikampeleka hospitali. Mamangu naye akapata shida ya miguu tukampeleka huko kwa askari wakasema na corona hii vile ilikuwa tunafunga mapema. Sasa kazi naye ikaharibika tu hivyo lakini sasa nakaa hivi nafikiria sasa.
And then like Scovia, Esther became pregnant.
So how do you generally feel about the fact that you're pregnant?
Nafurahi. I see your life, see you. Imekuwa ngumu sana upande yangu nikikuwa na mimba hivi.
It worries me that even though Esther's no longer working as a domestic, she's still facing difficulties in her life. The same cannot be said for the final former house girl who's truly thriving. And to meet her, I'm heading to the shores of Kenya's Lake Naivasha.
Hey! Mercy!
Mambo!
Hi!
Nice to see you!
Mercy has been training to be a chef. Now she's working full-time, managing a holiday home in this popular tourist destination.
I can see you look much happier here. Happier than the last time I saw you, for sure.
Yeah. I was not very happy, but right now, I am very happy.
And Mercy's never happier than when she's in her chef's whites. A far cry from the trouble she went through as a domestic worker.
So when you were doing domestic work, was that just because it was hard to get a different kind of job?
Yeah, it was also. I was doing that to get the money to go back to school to read the course that I wanted.
What course did you want?
I wanted to do this one for the catering.
Sitting down to Mercy's delicious cooking,
she's ready.
I'm delighted to see just how far she's come since we last met.
Looking at what you're able to do now, does it feel like you've come such a long way?
Right now I feel I'm a successful person because I've went through the course, I've learned from there, I've searched for a job. So I can say I feel great.
It's obvious Mercy takes great pride in her new job. But for Scovia, it's all about her family.
You still have the jackfruit tree. I remember this. Oh, and there's Grandma. Is that Grandma?
Yes.
Scovia's parents died when she was still little, leaving her grandmother to raise her.
Mefurahi kuona Scovia bado ako shule. Asante ku kumpa ule moyo wa kusema rudi shule, endelea na shule.
Sitting under the jackfruit tree, I talked to Scovia about her plans for the future.
Galia mtoto wako. Najisikiaje?
Najisikia tu raha.
Unafurahi. I think, you know, when I saw you in your school uniform, I was really impressed because when I met you, you'd gone to Kenya because you wanted to get the money to go back to school. Being a domestic worker was not your goal. School was your goal.
You can't just get a good job when you never went to school. I just want to be a responsible mother. I don't want to be given everything.
What do you dream of doing?
I want to help those orphans, those disadvantaged children.
Is that because of what you went through? Because you lost both your parents?
Because there are some children who never even went to school because they lost their parents. So that's why when I get a job, I also support the orphans so that they achieve on their education.
She's doing well and getting support with her studies, but Scovia is one of the lucky ones. Across Africa, teen pregnancy is on the rise, and in Uganda, nearly 650,000 were recorded between 2020 and 2021. And for an increasing number of young mothers, the prospect of continuing their education once the baby has arrived is impossible. For some, though, there is hope.
This is lovely. I mean, I wish it could fit me.
Give me that one.
In Lira, in the north of the country, Simon Ogwang runs a charity training teenage mothers on how to become seamstresses.
3 months. So you learned to make this in 3 months?
Yeah.
That's impressive. Very stylish.
So this is for babies.
So what's the whole aim behind this, of teaching the girls these design skills in the first place?
These girls, they are unable now to continue with their education. What we can give them for them to compete is specialized designs. It's a bit unique and competitive compared to other producers of clothes that they will go and meet in the community or in the market.
That makes a lot of sense. But you said many of these girls aren't able to continue with going back to school, so this makes this really important.
It makes important because they have no access to education. What else can they do?
Did the problem of teenage pregnancy get a lot worse in the COVID pandemic period?
During the pandemic period, we registered a lot of teenage pregnancy. And they closed down the schools, and this girl stays out. Girls are vulnerable. Some of them are at risk.
But why is it so difficult for these young mothers to continue their education?
So do schools send girls away when they get pregnant?
They don't send away, but the girls feel it's hard to stay at school. They still have that stigma. People still point at their back, like, this is the girl who was raped. This is the girl who was done this and this and that. So that person tomorrow will feel so bad to come back to school.
Do most girls who get pregnant go back to school, or do they just give up completely?
Most of the girls that get pregnant, they don't go back.
There are 45 girls at the center, all learning valuable skills.
I really want to hear from some of the girls themselves about their stories, but obviously they can be quite personal. So we're just going to go around away from the main group.
One of the young mothers being helped by Simon is 18-year-old Robina. Her story of suffering and stigma is typical of the hundreds of thousands of teenagers who became pregnant after the schools shut down.
I hope you know you're not any of those things that they say.
But Robina knows whatever happens, the only thing that matters is looking after her baby.
Has this helped being here with the other girls, learning a new skill? Do you feel like at least it's helped to give you some hope?
While Simon tries to help the young mothers in Lira, back in Namunyu, one expectant mother is trying to help herself. Esther is determined to get her shop back up and running.
Ya boutique yenye unajua tumenua nguo hii na hii. Kama huko unaweza enda Kampala, hizo ndio
zile mpya.
Zile mpya Kampala ndio bei nzuri. Ndio ilikuwa hardware. Hapa ndio nilikuwa naikanga cement. Hapa nilikuwa naikanga misumari. Sasa hiyo side nilikuwa nafungua ile mlango nikiuzia pale manguo.
At its height, the shop was thriving. It's hard to imagine that now, looking at the place.
Unajisikiaje ukija hapa kwa sababu ilikuwa biashara yako? Lakini sasa hamna kitu.
Sasa nasikia vibaya juu siwezi fungua biashara.
Lakini pia una hiyo hope kwamba utafungua tena biashara.
Niko na hiyo hope tu. Tumeweka shamba yetu kwa market. Munga akitusaidia tupate mtu mwenye atanunua. Baba anaweza nipatia pesa ndogo na nianze nayo na biashara ndogo.
It's not going to be easy for Esther to get things back how they were, but I get the sense she's determined to succeed.
It's really nice to see that you've come this far, and I know you know you have that never give up spirit.
Niko na dream ti nikirudisha biashara yangu itakuwa mzuri.
With Esther's baby due any day, all I can hope for is that everything works out for her. But now my journey takes me back to Nairobi, capital of Kenya, and home to almost 1 million domestic workers. It's also home to Edith Murogo, the woman who helped Esther, Scovia, and Mercy escape from domestic work. It was Edith they turned to when they were at their most vulnerable. And over the past 3 years, she's been continually supporting them.
When Esther, Scovia and Mercy decided they wanted a change from domestic work, this is where they came. 3 years later, I'm keen to see how Edith is getting on.
Since the last film, things have got a lot busier for Edith and her charity, the Centre for Domestic Training and Development.
Hi, Edith.
Hi, Mercy.
Welcome, welcome.
Thank you
for visiting us.
This place has changed.
Yes, we've grown quite a little bit.
One big change is the new housekeeping unit.
Karibuni, welcome.
Thank you.
It's been designed to introduce Edith's trainees to a whole new way of living.
Well, the trainees are coming from the rural areas. Mm. So, for example, now you can see this is a modern bathroom, you know, complete with a cubicle. Normally, they have not seen this before.
So, what percentage of the people who come would you say have never seen a bathroom like this?
I think for everyone. This is very modern stuff.
I mean, I'm just thinking about Scovia. I've been to her home. Yes. There's no way she would have seen anything like this before.
And because of that, they are taken advantage of in all ways, and they are seen as second-class citizens, and they are denied their rights.
I want to know what impact the original documentary and the stories of Scovia, Esther, and Mercy have had on the plight of domestic workers.
I think the visibility that was created and how it affects young women like Scovia and Mercy. And we have seen more and more referrals. Our program has grown more and more. We got global visibility from the documentary and received phone calls from people in the US.
And when you look at where Scovia, Esther, Mercy are now, yeah, compared to where they were 3 years ago, yeah, what would you say about where they are now?
I would say they're in a better place. Yeah, I'm really happy that each one of them is more focused, has a plan for their life. That is key. And that is what drives my passion.
One former house girl who's benefiting from Edith's passion is Beryl. She, together with two other former house girls, is now retraining to be a hairdresser.
So what are you doing today?
So I'm doing a blow dry, wash and blow dry.
Before this, you were doing domestic work. Yes. Is that something you wanted to get out of? And was this a way to get out of doing domestic work?
Yeah, this is a way to get over it, because domestic work and the environment was not good. Me getting out from there, it's something I'm so grateful of.
What do you see in the future?
I see a woman who is independent.
Wow.
Yeah, and a strong woman who can stand up for herself and speak out. Mm-hmm. And a woman who can support people who is going through what she went through.
Yeah.
I would not want even my worst enemy to go through what I went through.
Beryl reminds me of Mercy. Both suffered in domestic service, but both have tried to put those troubles behind them. But for Mercy, there is one issue that's still to be resolved. When we first met, Mercy was in the midst of a court case after claiming her former employer had tortured and imprisoned her. The case has been dragging on, but finally is nearing a conclusion.
Na kesi imekuwa inaendelea kwa muda mrefu, inaendaje?
Kwa muda, so kila wakati ukilala lazima utakumbuka, oh kumbe ni bado pia na all the best. Na nikidhani najua itaisha vizuri. Yeah.
Unaona kama hiyo kesi hajaisha bado huko. Yaani kama huwezi kuendelea mbele.
Yeah, naona bado siwezi endelea mbele. So na nangojea tu iishe. Then I'll be free.
For all the worry of the court case, Mercy seems very content in her new home.
Unapapenda?
Yeah, napenda. Yeah.
Hapana, sasa unajionea nini kwa future yako?
Mi kwa saizi mi naona naelekea pahali na bado hapo mahali tu natamania kufika hapo tu nitafika. With time nikiendelea vile ninaendelea. Najua ndoto yangu itakuja ikue ya ukweli.
Talking to Mercy, I'm optimistic that despite all the turmoil she's had to deal with, she does have the spirit and determination to succeed. And back in Nairobi, Edith tells me there's finally been a decision in Mercy's case. And it's not the outcome she's been hoping for. The court has found Mercy's former employer not guilty of the charges.
I am so disappointed with the verdict. This is because we really expected justice. We thought there was so much evidence, we thought it was a clear-cut case.
But what message do you think this case has sent out?
I think there's hope that at least these cases can also make their way into court and people should not give up.
I feel devastated for Mercy, but try to look at the positives.
As disappointing as this result has been, you must
still feel a little proud of what you've been able to help Mercy get into her life? I mean, she's doing so much better now.
Mercy is now more confident. She's happy. She has a skill. I think it has given her a sense of being, and she has come out resilient as a person.
I'm almost at the end of my journey when I get a message from Esther with some exciting news.
Ah, umeshapata mtoto.
Eh.
Hongera, hongera sana. Nimefurahi.
Eh.
Umeshampa jina?
Eh. Anaitwa Nancy. Nancy nambu ya Nancy Pretty.
Tulivyoongea ulisema so unataka ukishazaa ndio utaendelea tena kuangalia maisha, kufanya kazi.
Mungu akinisaidia nipate tu hata kapito ya kuanzia. Nataka nianze tena niendelee kufanya.
Najua kwamba utafanikiwa. Nimefurahi sana kumuona Pretty. Asante.
Karibu.
Sawa. Asante. Bye. Bye, baby.
Say bye.
These women have come a long way since I first met them 3 years ago. Esther's now a mother. Scovia is back at school. And Mercy is a qualified chef.
They put domestic work behind them, turned their lives around, and for the most part, are thriving.
And with support from people like Edith, there's hope that domestic work can be more than a place where dreams come to die.